Hello and welcome to the channel Automation Step by Step. So today I'm live on YouTube and I'm here to discuss with you. You can ask me your questions and I will also share some tips with you along this session. And before I begin the Q&A session, I want to thank all of you for 50,000 subscribers on this channel. So now we are a very, very big family of 50,000 members. And I also have some questions that that you have sent me. So I will also be answering those questions. And if you want to ask me any question, you can write in the comments. You can send me the comments and I will read out your message and I will try to answer it. So let us begin this session and I will take up some of the earlier questions that has been sent to me. So one of the questions that was sent to me was how to start a career in automation testing. So if you want to start a career in automation testing, you can start with any tool or any skills or any framework. Now, what I will suggest you is if you are already working into some organization, you can see what is the requirements there, what is the need there, and accordingly you can take up some automation tool which fits your need and then start working on that. Fortunately, we are living in a time where there are lots of free tutorials available online, and even if you have to go for some paid tutorials, you can do that and you can get the skills and start your career in automation. And if you want some very generic advice, I will say that you can start with Selenium, which is most widely used today in automation. And there is also a trend to move towards API testing and JavaScripting framework. So you can look at that as well. And then you can start your career into automation testing. So if you are already working, then look for what is the need in your organization and then start accordingly. The other question that I have got is, I want to learn automation from scratch and I want to create a Selenium automation framework. So how do I proceed? Very recently on this channel, I have started creating videos on creating a Selenium Java framework from scratch. So you can check the playlist and you can see those videos. And there I have, I am teaching from scratch, from very basic, how do you start these videos and how do you start creating a Selenium Java framework from scratch. So you can watch that playlist and very soon you will be you will come to know how to do those things. And even if you are a total beginner and you do not have any knowledge on programming or automation, I have created that series for complete beginners. So even if you do not have any prior knowledge, you can start on it and you can learn how to create a Selenium Java framework. So you can check my channel Automation Step by Step on YouTube and you can look at the playlist and you will find those videos. Let me see some other questions that I have got. Okay, so one of the questions I'm getting is how to troubleshoot issues. So here, when you go to any of your the videos on this channel or whenever you watch any tutorial, I will suggest that whenever you get any issue, just look at the comment section. So it is very much likely that your issue is very common and it has been faced by others earlier, and they must have posted some solution, or I might have replied already to that particular issue. So if you are watching the video and you are getting some issues during the your hands-on, then first always watch the comment section and see if it is already answered. And if you are not getting your solution there, then you can go to Google and just type your error or just type your issue there in Google search. If you are facing some particular error, just copy and paste it on Google search and you will find a lots and lots of options and articles. And there are a lot of good people who have suggested solutions. So you will always find your resolution there. So always do these two things. Check the comment section first and then finally go to Google and search for it. And finally, even if you are not getting any resolution by these two options, then always you can write down in the comment section and I will try to answer it as soon as I can. And of course, there are others who can help you as well. So you can do that. The other question I'm getting is, this was a question asked earlier by Azruddin, and it was, hi Raghav, what is SDET? How a normal automation tester will become SDET? So SDET is a acronym for Software Development Engineer in Test, and it is a role And this is suited for people who are both into, who have both the development skills as well as the testing skills. So you can think about SDET as a person who has development skills, testing skills, and can do automation testing as well. So he can contribute towards the development side as well as towards the testing side. Now, most of the organization, we see that in most of the organizations that there is a gap between the dev team and the QA team. So SDET is a role that bridges these gaps and can help in both the ways and can also bring more of development into testing so that he can create unit testing, he can create automation frameworks, and he can also suggest the development team according to what is the QA needs, and he can drive development in the way it is most efficient for QA and vice versa. So you can look at this role as creating a gap or creating a bridge between dev teams and QA teams and bridging this gap. And if you want to go into SDET role, then of course you need dev skills as well as testing skills. So this is what SDET is all about. So let me see if I have got any more questions here. And one of the questions we have got is, can I start on automation testing without any development background? So this is a very common question that I get almost every week. Somebody asks me this question that he does not have any background on coding or development and he wants to come into automation. So the answer is definitely yes. Even if you do not have any development background, any coding background, you do not know any programming languages, that is completely okay. You can come into automation, you can start automation. The only thing that is required is you should be ready to learn during your automation journey. So whenever there is need to learn any programming concepts or anything, you can do that. And then there are so many automation tools where you do not need to go so deep into development. You just need to understand the concepts well and you can do fine in automation. So there is this is not a very hard prerequisite that you should know development, you should know some programming languages before coming to automation. The only thing is you should be ready to learn along with your learning of automation. So that was one question. The other question I am getting here is, I don't have any hands-on web application nor with the GUI automation. I have uploaded my CV in job portal. I am not getting any calls from 3 months. Can you suggest tips on skills, tips or skills I can add up? So this is asked by Anoop. So Anoop, I will say that I will suggest you that you build your resume and your CV accordingly, and you should always have a general CV where you can put all your details, all your experiences, all your skills, and all your projects. And then whenever you want to apply for a particular job, then read the job description very carefully and find out the keywords, find out their requirements and their needs. And then now you create a copy of your general resume and now format it according to the needs of that particular job. So read the job description and then highlight what exactly the job needs, highlight your skills accordingly, and keep your resume very, very simple and do not clutter it, because I have experienced that the interviewers go through a lot of resumes. They do not have a lot of time to go through each and every details. So on the very first page, just highlight your skills which are most relevant for that particular job. And then that will be very useful. And this is how you can start applying. So always read the job description and then create your resume accordingly. So now let me just see what are the other questions I'm getting here. So one question I'm getting again from Anoop is, so this was a question asked earlier. Recently, I came across a tool called Testing Wiz. Is it worth learning? So Anoop, any knowledge is worth learning. So if you are getting any knowledge from anywhere and it's a good knowledge, there is no harm in learning it. So you can go for it. Other question I'm getting is, can you suggest some skills for DevOps and testing, combination of testing and DevOps? So DevOps is more of a process than a combination of some tools. Some people think like if you can learn some tools you can learn DevOps. It is not like that. DevOps is a process, and there are some tools that enable this process of DevOps. And DevOps run in the entire lifecycle of any product or any service. So what I can suggest you is, if you still want to, you know, go through some tools and learn DevOps, then you can take up some CI tool like Jenkins. Jenkins is very widely used. You can learn Chef, you can learn Puppet, you can learn a version control tool like Git. You can also learn some other automation tools. Selenium will also help. You can learn some application lifecycle monitoring tools. So this is how you can start. You can take up one tool from all of these phases and start learning. And that will be the first step towards DevOps. So you can do you can learn DevOps like that. And let me see if we have got some more questions here. Okay, so I think this is all for today. And if you liked this particular live stream, let me know on the comment section. And if it is very useful, we can make it a regular event and we can make it a weekly event. And most of you have sent me messages that you want to talk to me and ask me questions. So of course, it can be very difficult for me to interact with everyone one-to-one. So this can be a platform. These live sessions can be a platform where you can meet me, where you can ask your questions, and where I will help you with your queries. So that was all for today's live stream. I hope this was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.